Forza Horizon 5, when's it coming out? Where's it gonna be? There's a lot of speculation out there right now about Forza Horizon 5, mainly focused on when it will launch and where it will be set. I think there is a good case for Forza Horizon 5 to release in 2021, but first let's talk about the location. Early rumors suggested Japan, which would be awesome, and I think a lot of people really wanted that and still want that. But I don't think there's any substance to that claim, and it seems like it's kind of been disproved at this point. More recent rumors suggest Mexico, which would also be a fantastic location. This stems from some chatter on Twitter from Xbox insider Jeff Grubb and the senior editor of Window Central, which is a well-respected outlet for all things Xbox if you're not familiar with it, but they had suggested that it would be nice to visit Mexico. Now, Jeff Grubb has been right on a lot of things in the past when it comes to rumors, and I don't think Window Central is trying to just get clicks or be clickbaity, so there very well could be some substance to this, even though it's kind of a lot of inferring from cryptic tweets. Grubb also thinks we will see Forza Horizon 5 in 2021, but before we dig into that, if you guys are excited for this game and if this game does release this year, be sure to make sure you are subscribed so you don't miss anything related to Forza Horizon 5. Alright, let's talk about Mexico as a potential location and why it makes sense. So if you think about it, Forza maps take a lot of inspiration from the countries they are set in, and the developers seem to like variety, especially within the kind of landscape or the country and regions that they're trying to represent, if you will. We've already gone to Colorado, Southern Europe, Australia, and Great Britain. Right, they wanted to do these locations justice so people who are not from there could get a glimpse of the country, and then they also want to make sure they please kind of the home crowd of the people who actually live there, right, with a good representation. Xbox had a fairly strong base in Australia and Great Britain, and both have a great culture, so they made a lot of sense. And Forza and Xbox are gaining in popularity in Spanish-speaking countries, whereas Sony dominates Japan. So even on the surface, Mexico could make a lot of sense, especially more so than Japan. Plus, Mexico has a ton of landscapes and biomes that could provide great variety. I mean, you have deserts, rainforests, mountains, coastal roads and beaches, you name it. Not to mention Mexico City, which is huge and could be really cool. And then all kinds of ancient ruins. So there's tons there to work with. However, if we do end up going to Mexico, while it may be bigger than Great Britain in real life, I don't think we'll see a much bigger base map than we did in Forza Horizon 4, mainly because Forza Horizon 5 will be released on Xbox One if it releases this year so that Microsoft can maximize their player base, and the developers have already come out and said what they did in Forza Horizon 4 was about as big as they could do in terms of the map size for the quality they were going for on that hardware. So this makes a lot of sense since Horizon is kind of the bigger moneymaker at this point than Motorsport, and it helps the case for Forza Horizon to be released before Motorsport to maximize the player base. The other thing to think about is the seasonal gameplay cycle Playground seems pretty committed to. Mexico obviously has much less of a seasonal change than Great Britain, so I'm not really sure how that will work, but I'm sure a lot of people will be really happy about the removal of winter. I personally don't care that much, but I know a lot of people have complained about the winter weeks in Forza Horizon 4, but if we do end up going to Mexico, it'll be very curious to see how they tie in weather and the seasons, or if they do seasons at all. But I do think it could be really cool to kind of have dynamic weather as you drive through the base map instead of seasons that change the whole map. So for like example, you all in the same map, you could drive in the desert where there's not really going to be any rain. But then as you drive along the coast or into the rainforest, you have some rain. And then if you go up into the mountains, you got snow and snowstorms and blizzards and stuff. That could be really cool. But I don't know, I'm not a game developer, so I have no idea if the engine's even capable of doing that. I'm just thinking out loud that would be pretty cool. And at the end of the day, remember, this is all speculation, nothing's been confirmed. I'm just some dude on the YouTube, right? So take it all with a grain of salt. But now let's get into the meat and potatoes here, a potential 2021 release and why it seems likely. It's been 3 years now since we've had a new Forza game. And this is a game that usually releases annually. And by this, I mean that Forza as a franchise has been alternating Motorsport and Horizon to have a game release every year. And currently, it's been almost 3 for Horizon and almost 4 for Motorsport. So now you're thinking, wait, doesn't that mean they should release Motorsport 8 first since it's been longer? Wait, there's more! Microsoft supposedly has some big unannounced games releasing this year. the reboot or whatever of Forza Motorsport or Forza Motorsport 8, whatever you want to call it, has already been announced, as well as a bevy of other big games for Xbox, like Halo and Fable, yada yada, right? So there's already some games. I mean, Fable's not releasing this year, but Halo supposedly is. And we haven't been given a release window for the new Motorsport. So could we see a Forza Horizon 5 reveal at E3? I don't know. I certainly hope so. I think it's likely based on what we know at the moment, but I should also bring up that even if they announce it at E3, it may not release this year anyway, especially with everything currently going on in the world. And also, as I mentioned before, Microsoft will likely want to release Forza Horizon 5 on Xbox One as well if it releases this year, because this helps keep their player base as large as possible. Forza Horizon 4 is now on Steam, it's optimized for Series S and X, and all that has breathed new life into the game. So the iron is hot, if you will, right? It makes a lot of sense for them to strike right now. I also think the developers may be planning the next Forza Motorsport as a Series X and S like exclusive and PC because of how ambitious I think they want to be with that game, and kind of the technical aspects that come with that. Not only just in the physics and the handling of the cars and the environment, but also the capabilities like ray tracing that are, you know, being hyped up at the moment. So we'll have to see. One thing that could go either way is Playground Games' involvement in the next Fable game, going back to that really quick. Particularly the news that the new Fable will run on Forza Horizon's engine. This makes sense for a number of reasons. The most obvious is the dynamic open world they created in Forza Horizon 4. I say this could go either way because it could mean that they are ready to wrap up Forza Horizon 5 and take what they learned into the development of Fable, or it could mean a delay for Forza Horizon and that Motorsport may indeed be ready first. I don't know. It could also be irrelevant because maybe Playground Games is a big enough studio now to work on two AAA games at once. I don't know. Again, I'm just some guy on the YouTube. Lastly, and I have no evidence for this, but if EA was anticipating Forza Horizon 5 to release this year as well, that could also help explain why they elected to delay Need for Speed. Because Forza Horizon 4, or Forza Horizon as a series in general, is much more of a direct competitor than Forza Motorsport, since that's kind of a sim racer. Well, not kind of, it is a sim racer. Whereas Forza Horizon is more arcadey, and Need for Speed is an arcade racer. Forza's kind of been better, Forza Horizon has been better than Need for Speed for some time now, so if EA is looking to make a big splash with the next Need for Speed game and try and rebuild the franchise, which I'm cautiously optimistic that they are, I'm sure they would much rather launch a year later than one of their main competitors, aka Forza Horizon 5. But I'd love to know your guys' thoughts. Let me know down below in the comments what you think about Forza Horizon 5 in Mexico, a 2021 release window, or you could think I'm an idiot. Doesn't matter. Leave a comment. But that's going to do it for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and think about subscribing if you're new. Till next time, stay classy.